chisorer shared the stage here with Osama Sizzler. Now they meet all over again in a compelling rematch of their classic in 2016. Repeat or revenge, and it's a fast start from chisorer as expected.
Well, I think you can cut the tension with a knife, and you can feel the anticipation of this match. Who's going to land first? What's White going to do? He's going to box a move. Is chisorer going to steam forward like he said he's going to? Let's just see what happens here. Round one, then head to head, really.
Well, I find interesting. These are heavyweights, 17 stone 8, and they're coming out throwing punches. I want to see the punch sets for this first round, because it seems like it's going to be very, very hot. They come out with intent, and I'm very happy.
Shots from chisorer. Listen to the crowd who are behind him. Right hand from White, and they're engaging early, very early.
This is what we want to see. This is big boy boxing. Oh, they know what's on the line. Come on, chisorer.
Oh, big right hand shot. White smiling through the gum shield.
Dylan White hurt him there earlier, that right hand, and you see chisorer step back on unsteady legs as early as that. That's bad signs there for chisorer so early on in the fight.
What I found so interesting is Dylan didn't go in with the instinct. He took his time.
Another right hand from White. Just waiting off and behind the jab as well.
Well, he's taking his time. Dylan White just waiting for that counter. And Derek Chisora just walking forward. Unusually keeping himself open for that right hand. He seemed to dip and slide and roll better than what he's doing. And the right hand just landed too clean, too early.
Dylan is really taking his time. It seems like he's trying to set up the counter punches. He knows that's what's effective. Derek's getting his senses back. Still on his front foot, interestingly.
4 years younger, Dylan White. Chisora, fight number 38. But he has had what he says has been the best training camp ever. Whipped into shape by Don Charles. Ruben Tavares, a conditioner part of it. Nice right hook there from Chisora, who says he will break down White and stop him this time.
Well, maybe that early right hand that landed on Chisora knocked him on unsteady legs. Seemed to just woke him up. A lot of talking going on there between the two guys. Maybe Chisora, I think, just trying to get inside White's head, who's not biting.
White trying to get the jab going again. He has got the advantage in boxing skills, surely, with that long reach. So the maturity and improvement in the last couple of years, and that was a nice right hand from White.
Yeah, just falling short of Chisora, managing to get it to bounce off his shoulder. Good defense there from Chisora, it was close. But you can see what White's looking at doing. I mean, he's kind of waiting for Chisora to come in so he can look for the counter punch, and he's done that very well in that round.
Where we left off. Thoughts on that first round, Anthony?
This is so intense. You know I'm a fan of boxers, so I'm here shouting and screaming, but you know, they came out at a fast pace. Punch that's I really want to know, as I said, at a fast pace. And then I realised that Dylan is trying to set up the counters because he knows that's a shot that will hurt Chisora, which he did. But what I find interesting is why he didn't go in and try and take him up there and then. You don't get paid for overtime in boxing. So I'm going to find that really interesting what his game plan is later on down the line.
Chisora, there was all that madness in the build-up last time. Glasses thrown, tables turned over. This one has been calm by comparison. A much happier Derek Chisora as he wades in with a right hand and a left hook. And Dylan White, who's done everything professionally as ever up in Loughborough, he's got a really good training regime and he stands on the cusp, surely now, of a world title fight, providing he can make a statement tonight.
Yeah, you get a feeling White needs a good performance to make that statement here tonight, Adam. And Chisora, I think, caught a little bit cold early on in round one. He needs to get back behind that nice defence, get a head moving as he is doing now. But White's just being very good with that jab, very effective. And you know the right hand will be on the end of that jab, just like that. And they're hurtful shots.
Yeah, big right hand from White, who said that he doesn't mind.
team just this early on. You just feel he's got that confidence behind him. He's smiling as he's backed up by Derek Chisorer. He's not really concerned, but he still needs to be very careful as Chisorer walks forward because he's got some hurtful looking hooks.
Good combination from Dylian Whyte. He started well.
And this fight is interesting because it will show who has studied and what they've learned from their first encounter. This fight is a rematch and it's going to show who has learned and who's going to put it into practice tonight.
Looking for the hook come up and go there. Dylian Whyte, who's had those wins over Lucas Brown and Joseph Parker. And Chisorer, yeah, that bad performance in Monaco, but then that dramatic victory over Carlos Takam. He sat back on the ropes that night. He's not doing it here. He's ploughing forward, but is he ploughing forward into Dylian White's hands?
Well, he seems to be walking into too many counter punches. Short little uppercut there from Dylian White, and he's looking for that right hand as well, but he's happy to sit there and mix it up with Derek Chisorer as he walks forward. He's not going to run White. He's going to just sit back behind the jab, maybe look for the uppercut like he did there, come back with a hook nicely.
I think they've been working on that uppercut. He's fine with David Allen. Derek Chisorer and Brian Jennings, and they get all tangled on the ropes. And Marcus McDonald just wants a timeout.
I think Chisorer will just get a bit rough there, but the gamemanship, he always like he can't help himself. Referee not happy with that there from Derek Chisorer. I think he's going to have a stern word with him here.
We can't deny that, you know, he stripped some weight, but that's good for him. You know what, he stayed in there, he took one of Dylan's best punches with the overhand right, and he's still here now. This is a fight of two sides, first half and second half, first six and second six. So if it does go past the first six, it'll be really interesting to see how Derek comes on later on in the fight. Right now, Dylan's taking the lead, staying relaxed, but will he still have that same energy in the second half of the fight?
It's pulsating again, isn't it, Carl?
It's a straight away, early on, we've had two really intense rounds. I mean, Dylian Whyte has taken the round. So Chisorer's now starting to just close that gap a little bit better.
If you need the identification, the blue and black of Dylian Whyte and the silver, grey and white of Derek Chisorer, but I'm sure you know them well. The WBC silver and the WBO international belts on the line, but it's really all about pride and about securing, surely, a shot at one of the champions of 2019. Chisorer with big shots raining in the third.
Well, Chisorer now, as he backs up one, he's rolling his head a bit better, moving that head. Maybe he's had some advice from his corner. As he walks forward, move that head, and White will slip the shots over a miss. And when he gets there, Chisorer, he really is setting his feet and pounding in his body in a head shot. White quite comfortable, but Derek Chisora's going to make this rough.
Shoulder going in as well. All the old tricks from Derek Chisorer. Watch the head, says Marcus McDonald. He has that experience. The hardened rounds he shared with the likes of Vitali Klitschko.
Well, there's a better head movement here from Chisorer as he backs up White, getting close and being more effective. But you just get the feeling that White can wait for that one big shot.
Stylistically, gelling again so beautifully.
Really nice. I mean, the body shots as well from Chisorer looking good, and that's good tactics just to take the legs away from White.
Chisorer seems to have warmed up now. You know, Dylan's been controlling the first two rounds. Chisorer's on the front foot a lot. And as we said, it's a fight of two halves. So it's interesting, as the fight warming up, how it's going to switch ends. But this is what we love between these two. A great battle right the way through.
White just missing with an uppercut by a whisker. Body shot from Chisorer.
Some crunching body shots from Chisorer, switching up to the head as well. This is good work here as he backs up White.
They are both throwing haymakers.
Oh, big shot!
Swinging and moving. Dylan's keeping his hands up. Great defense, pushing Chisorer back. Chisorer gets straight back, whips into the body, and we know how much energy that takes out of you.
Yeah, them body shots are good and are very effective here from Chisorer.
Here we go again. Thunderous action, and it's very early in the rematch. Just what we wanted.
Well, we asked for round 13, and that's what we got. This really has picked up where it left off.
Big hooks being swung in, that slightly low. Now it's Dylian White's turn for a slight ticking off, but you can't take your eyes off it.
Derek Chisorer not complaining there with that low blows. He just wants to get down to business, and now this really is edge of your seat stuff.
You have to remember, this is only the third round. These guys are in phenomenal shape. Dylan is there throwing hooks. That's one of his best shots, that counter left hook. Chisorer's coming in low, trying to swing them over the top. I want to see how they feel when they come out for the fourth round, because they are definitely warming up into a great fight right now.
Right hook from Chisorer, throwing so much leather early. Really driving these punches. There's the uppercut again from Whyte as they go toe-to-toe. Trench warfare in the O2, and the crowd already on their feet. And we've only had three rounds. Well, the Thunder Holyfield have really bested it twice, and it was an amazingly poor pace for heavyweights. Are we getting that here?
They had a trilogy.
Of course they did.
And we mentioned whether they would be one of the press conferences earlier in the week. I tell you, it just can't get better. It's fantastic.
I'm loving this. I'm wondering if one of them can tag team me in there. I want to get involved in this right now. I've got that buzz. Do you know what I mean? It's phenomenal. I'm really impressed by what these guys are doing. Their training team, let's not forget them. The people behind the scenes, they put in a lot of time and effort into these guys. And this is the finished article, so thank God for British boxing right now.
Absolutely, Mark James. And here's Dylian Whyte team. And of course, Don Charles and the new V-Maker team. There's Jarrell Miller. Big baby, he wants you, Anthony. It's all happening.
Boring.
I tell you what's not boring, it's what's happening in the ring in front of us. Here's the fourth. Can this go the distance again at this pace, Carl?
Well, I don't see how it can. I mean, the first half of the fight is a lot different to the second half as the athletes become slower and the feet become flat. These big heavyweights will tire at some point, but I'm not sure who's going to give up. I just cannot separate them at this moment.
Dylian Whyte. That was a big shot from Whyte, taken well by Chisorer as the crowd get behind him again.
Well, it's them counter right hands from Dylian Whyte that seem to be the difference. They're really effective, and they're the shots that we can see, Anthony, the eye-catching shots. And Chisorer seems to be affected as they hit him. His legs seem to buckle slightly. He's still in there, still looking strong, still backing up Whyte, but them right hands that are waiting for him from Whyte seem to be bothering.
It's when those two forces hit, Chisorer coming forward and Dylian Whyte coming forward, and it hits him flush on the chin. But as we said, we saw what he'd done in round one. He's staying in there. He just needs to avoid those counter right hands. I'm not saying that's going to be the decider of the fight, but it'll make it an easier fight for Chisorer. All we can see here, he's swinging him to the body, and I'm sure his game plan is to slow Dylian Whyte down.
And it's a good tactic, but I've not seen Whyte really hurt yet, but I've seen Chisorer buckle a couple of times.
Correct. You can see Dylian Whyte's really improved there. He's counter-punching, he's being clever. You can see it's not just about war, it's about tactician and technical boxing. But sometimes you just get drawn into a scrap and you've got to dig deep. And this is what Chisorer's going to bring out of Whyte. And how much far has he got?
And what a chin Derek Chisorer has shown over the years. Only David Hay found the answers to get rid of him. And he's now just getting some momentum here in the fourth round. And for the first moment, a big gulp of air from Dylian Whyte.
Yeah.
That's what Chisorer had there, the momentum going forward. He was able to out-muscle Whyte on his back foot to get him off balance, but looked like he was in some kind of trouble there, Whyte.
It's bumping together as well in there. It's rough and it's tough. There's the left hook from Chisorer. He said he will not be denied this time around.
Well, you hear the oohs and wahs from Anthony Joshua as he's big shots, because you can hear and feel these thunderous hands from both fighters. Yeah, they both really are swinging it with extreme power. They're both putting all their power into this. I can't see how this fight goes the distance now.
This is where the fight is very, very dangerous. When both men are hurt, both men are tired, this is when it's very dangerous. This is a fight. Dylan did throw a shot at the ref, told him to break, but it's a fight, and I see Dylan is in a stage where he has to do what he has to do. This is turning into a dangerous fight for both of them.
Chisorer backing off. Was he hurt or was he playing possum? A change of tactics maybe as Whyte gets behind the jab. We expected him to use his more, you know, rounded skills, didn't we, Whyte? But he loves a war too. It's a slow war back to the corner for Derek Chisorer.
It's a war! Take it on and implement any kind of tactical change. I think Chisorer's got
to support Derek tonight. Big hero of yours, really, at Finchley too, Derek.
I'm so impressed by what he's achieved. You know, came through the ABAs, and now he's fighting here in front of a packed crowd at the O2. We really got to support these fighters and what they're putting in, because I'm sitting there on the outside entertained and loving it.
He got the golden ticket, didn't he, when he somehow beat Carlos Takan in July. And that is the rematch with Dylian Whyte that he so craved. Carl's unofficial card has it level. So too Anthony Joshua, so too Spencer Oliver. Johnny Nelson just has chisorer slightly in front. It's all to fight for, and that's what this is, another brutal fight. Big left hand from chisorer, partially blocked by Whyte, and another one that gets through.
These boys can definitely take a punch. They're eating leather.
Well, I think Whyte's favourite points is to block that hook and return it with a left hook of his own, which he wasn't too far away with that one. But chisorer, he just got momentum going forward, and I like the tactics of just keep picking away the body of Whyte, just sending him in. And he can slow down Whyte with a heavy body shot, which I'm sure he can then be more effective later on.
Carl, Adam, can you see why I was so interested? Why Dylian Whyte didn't take his opportunity in the first round? Because now it's turned into a real even fight.
Yeah, he's come right back there, chisorer, the last couple. That was a good shot though from Whyte. The single punches might be crisper, but the sheer persistence here of Derek Chisora, it's just whether he can keep it going, whether they've got him in that brilliant shape to go through 12 rounds. 38 knockouts between them, and neither could be shifted in Manchester.
I think to answer your question there, Anthony, you know, Whyte didn't win a lot of risk, just caught off balance there. Whyte backed up by Chisora, nothing really big landing. The crowd, you know, they see something different from a bit further afield, but certainly a lot of action really heating up in there. But I don't think Whyte wanted to go for broke. He did stun Chisora early in round one, and he just thought, you know what, I'm just going to fight my time, and that's what he's doing here. But that can be a dangerous plan.
It's such a, well, in my opinion, it's a dangerous plan. But you know what, Cole, you're a fighter, you know how these guys feel in there. Oxygen levels, heart rate high, giving everything they got. I think these guys are just fighting off of instinct right now.
Well, it's a lot worse for the big guys, as you know, when you're trying to run with the smaller weights.
Really good combination went in from Dylian Whyte about 30 seconds or so ago. He's being warned for the use of the head again, Derek Chisora.
That breather and that warning is like a lifeline to these guys. Get their breather, watch them go again.
Because it's so grueling, so early.
Correct. And as we saw early on, Dylian was boxing, moving, but now he's in there trading, throwing haymakers with him.
Well, he was always going to have to hold his feet and meet Derek Chisora as he came. But these body shots are really good from Derek Chisora. These have been working away at Whyte.
They're really accurate as well, aren't they? Yeah. Especially with the left hand, just under the elbow of Dylian Whyte.
Well, he's there busy defending his head, thinking, I don't want to get caught by them big head shots. Yeah, nice left hook there from Chisora, right on the belt. Still got Whyte on his back foot, still looking for that overhand right there. Whyte was able to
to just ride that as he saw it coming. They both already seem in better shape than they were 2 years ago.
Definitely. I mean, they've been talking a good one in the fitness and the training camp. It's getting more and more scientific now, boxing, and you know, most sports, they've taken the nutrition, they balance the food against the hydration, and it's really important. Some of the explosive training has changed as science has moved on, and both of these guys in here are at their ultimate peak as far as I'm concerned.
Again, big body shot from Chisora. White looking for those counts as he's so dangerous with a left hook, as Joseph Parker felt in this very ring in July. But remember, White was hanging on right at the end after that knockdown. Another 30 seconds, he might not have made it.
It's good head movement, good work as Chisora backs up. Dylan White, nice two body shots there, well by AJ next to me. Because they're crunching body shots and a nice hook. It's a good movement, a good cross-arm defence from Chisora. White's going to have to try and catch him with something on his way in, or this will start to tire Dylan White.
Look, this is, some people call this domestic fighting, British level fighting. This is world-class heavyweight boxing. I'm really impressed with these two. Like I said, they're going into the second half of the fight. Taking their time now, they've got to be clever. As I said, their heart rates are high, their cardiovascular system is definitely working. And it's whoever has more heart. Chisora's trying to stay in there and win the rounds, stealing the rounds. It's quite even, but I mean, he stole this round, and it's interesting to see how we'll go on as we head into the seventh.
And some of these rounds, again, very difficult to split them, very difficult to score for the three judges at ringside. We had that in Manchester, so I thought Chisora nicked it. White got the decision, others thought a draw. It was so close.
It was very close, split everywhere. Derek Chisora doing more work this round, and White just having a bit of a round off, just backing up, looking for the odd counter, but not really getting a home with anything.
Yeah, he's backed up on the ropes there. White, is he looking for a breather here in the sixth?
You have to be clever. These haymakers that Chisora's been throwing since round one take it out of you. Dylan's being clever, staying in, yes, trying to win into the body.
That was a good right hand there from Chisora. Did I see the legs there just slightly dipped from White?
Yes, you did.
Back he comes with a body shot, White, but it's a Chisora round, and it's White that has to hold on to the ropes over in the blue corner.
Well, Chisora came out with a ferocious pace, working the body as we're seeing here. Left hook, right hook, getting his head on the chest of Dylan White. Just manhandling there, pushing him back as he gets momentum moving forward. White's looking for the counter, looking for the uppercut as he's backed up. But it's difficult when you're being pushed around.
See Tony Belly there, good friend of Chisora, giving him advice outside of the ring. People are standing up, it's a passionate moment.
It's the passion of the sport, isn't it? You fight it.
Two old enemies in there, Belly.
Exactly, David Hayes, Tony Belly there, both in the corner.
Enemies there, Hayes with Chisora, it's a mad world, isn't it?
What's so wonderful about this sport of boxing, I mean, it just brings people together and turns people against each other in so many weird and wonderful ways, but ultimately we're all professional sportsmen.
Second half of the brawl to settle it all, but will it settle it all? Or will we be looking for fight number three in the new year? Carl has Chisora one up. The feeling at ringside is a little bit split. Matt Macklin has it level. Spencer Oliver, a couple up to Chisora. Anthony, what are you thinking?
Well, honestly, I have it level right now. This is why the second half is so interesting. It's all about instinct and heart. They slowed down the pace a little bit. They've got to be a bit clever, because this is who's going to go on and either get the knockout or steal the fight in the eyes of the public.
Here comes Chisora again, and White answers.
Yep.
Well, White has to fight back, because if Chisora is able to just walk forward, get his body weight moving, and land them hooks and shots, it's going to look like he's getting the better of White. So White answered back nicely there, but Chisora really putting him under some serious pressure. Can White do anything about this? And can Chisora keep this pace up?
Again, Marcus McDonald holds Derek Chisora's head. I mean, a point off at some point could be crucial in a fight as close as this.
When Chisora steams forward, it's a great tactic, keeping your head down and swinging him over the top. It avoids any counter punches. So it's a tactic that's going to get him in trouble, but a tactic that's going to get him through this fight. Ducking and diving, slipping and sliding. That's what Derek needs to continue to do while Dylan keeps on popping out that jab and looking for that right-hand counter.
A momentary respite from the all-out slugfest that at times it's been, but quality as well, especially with the body shots of Chisora, the uppercuts from White. They're finding great punches in there too.
They certainly are. I mean, the pace has dropped now, and it should do. This is the second half of the fight. You know, this is the stage now where they're going to have to think about what they're doing, try and conserve their shots. But Chisora still looking for the big shot, still steaming forward with his head down. And what liable to really catch him clean on the way in.
Chisora does not take a step back, stumbled back and comes straight forward again, putting that pressure on Dylian White.
Well, that's his tactic, that's what he said he was going to do, and he's true to his word.
Seek and destroy, said Derek Chisora, even then when he swings and misses. And White backs him up into the corner. Chisora comes off again.
Well, that's maybe where White should have maybe stepped on him and let some shots go, but he opted to sit back and have a bit of a breather.
Is he caught a bit betwixt and between here, Dylian White?
Dylian White's being clever. This is a tactical fight. It's the energy. He knows he's not at 50%. He'll save his energy and rather trade when he's 80%. It's a clever tactic from a clever fighter.
Heavier shots going in from Derek Chisora. White catching him with some cheeky little counter shots on the way in, but the heavy work and the eye-catching stuff coming from Chisora for the bulk of that round.
Let's find out what Big Baby thinks. Jarrell Miller with Andy.
Jarrell, welcome to the UK. I hope you're enjoying it. How are you scoring it?
I got a 5-2 for Chisora. Better pressure, better combination, go to the body. Dylian White's backing up too much. One thing for sure is, if he's fighting like that against Chisora, he's only 238 backing him up. 30 pounds out of me, I'm going to demolish him.
Is this how you thought the fight would go beforehand? To win?
Chisora. I'm for the underdog.
And would you fight Chisora?
Hell yeah. Any day of the week.
Okay, enjoy the rest of your night.
Jarrell Miller, a part in the heavyweight picture in the new year. Anthony Joshua alongside us, Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury, all at the very top. And these two, what a crack. Would you like Dylian White next, the rematch?
I'd like Deontay Wilder.
That's the key for you?
Yeah, that's the key for the fans, and it's the key for legacy. But also, if it wasn't Wilder, it's a brilliant opportunity for Dylian or the winner of this fight to get their hands on their title. So I'd love to give one of my fellow British heavyweights a shot at the title.
Well, Derek Chisora, should he surprise the bookies?
Ooh, that was a funny shot. But what I find interesting is Dylian White is not stepping on the gas when he's hurting Chisora. He's staying back and still sticking to his boxing.
Well, that's probably his game plan, and he's being very disciplined because...
Very disciplined.
When he does catch Chisora, he doesn't seem to go for any kind of finish. Is that because he's worried about his energy levels, or is that just purely tactics?
Well, this is a good question.
Good body shot. Sorry to interrupt, guys. Good body shot there from Dylian White.
It is.
It just squeaked in there, and a bit of a smile too.
He seems to be smiling like he's happy with himself, with his work, and he's talking to Chisora in there, as if to say, I caught you there and I know about it. And Chisora does seem to have slowed down slightly this round, not as ferociously. Yes. Pace is coming forward, and White will be more comfortable with this. This kind of pace suits White.
But what's interesting, sitting from the outside, we don't know what's going through these fighters' heads. As we're wondering why Dylian isn't stepping on the gas when he's hurting Chisora, as we're wondering why Chisora is taking his foot off the gas when he had Dylian on the back foot, they are up to something big, and something's going to spark very soon.
Well, Chisora played his leg on.
Marcus McDonald comes in again. And it's another warning. It will be a point next time.
Believe it or not, the referee warning you takes a chip off your shoulder. It demoralises you a little bit. The ref has a big involvement and a big dictatorship in how the fight goes. So Derek needs to clear his head, as he's been warned a few times, and just stick to what he's doing, swinging him into the body and the head.
Yeah, Dylian White being backed up, but taking a lot of shots on the gloves.
Yes,
no, he's not really getting caught with anything clean, and then answering back and countering as he puts Chisora on his back foot.
There's a bounce to Dylian White now. There's a shift in the plot again here in the eighth round. Body shot from White. Suddenly he looks stronger and sturdier. And Chisora not delivering as much. And there's a timeout here. Is it for a low blow? What's going to happen? Marcus McDonald is taking a point off Derek Chisora.
That is the real shame. It was borderline shots. He did have a warning. Dylian White wasn't complaining, so I mean... The referee's got a job to do. He's close to the laws.
That's what I mean.
But it wasn't anything malicious or sinister in them shots. I mean, is Johnny just, you know, on the belt line. So I think that's harsh. In a fight that's so close, like Adam said earlier, that could be the difference. That'd be a shame for a point deduction to be the difference in such a great fight.
Well, hopefully that gives Chisorer a bit of motivation. Hopefully it gives Dylan a bit of motivation. Chisorer to think I need to bounce back, and Dylan to think I need to steal this fight while I can, and it creates for a great slugfest.
It's been a clever around this from Dylian White. But a right hand from Chisorer. Just a reminder, late on, back comes White. Last few seconds of a dramatic eighth.
And they start trading again. Saved by the bell.
Let's get over to Tony Melly with Andy.
Tony, you're living every punch. You got Derek ahead even with that point deduction.
Thank you.
just boxing well, taking a lot of shots, but giving a lot of shots back. Both of these guys really working so hard. The fight's close, but White's just edging it for me.
Which way are you leaning?
Let me count the rounds here.
I've got Spencer Oliver says level. Johnny Nelson has Dylian White 2 up. Matthew Macklin, Dylian White 1 up.
I'm counting the level as well. You know, it's interesting. I was wondering why Dylan was taking rounds off. I saw him as he got up out of his corner. He looks fresh. He doesn't look too tired. And I'm sure that's his game plan now in the later rounds to come on heavy. I can't see how Chisorer's looking, but looking at Dylan, he looks fresh and he looks ready to come out in this round.
The three judges at ringside, two from America, Mauro Di Furio, Fernando Barbosa, and one from England in John Latham, just in front of us. And the scoring shots, a lot of the quality at times has come from Dylian White in those single shots, although the work rate from Chisora.
So a lot of the work from Chisora has knocked down the gloves, and all good defense from White. And White's able to just land the counter punches, but there's not much on White's counter punches now, just picking cheeky little shots, but they are scoring shots. You get the feeling that if Derek Chisora doesn't land something eye-catching, doesn't land something that's going to have an effect, this fight might just run away with it.
And he's got the point off, remember, as well.
He certainly has. I mean, in round 8, Fox McDonald, he looked to the point for a low blow. It was harsh. But there's the rules, and we have to take that into account later on.
I was wondering why Derek kept on hitting Dylan to the body, and as I was looking closely, Dylan had a tight guard that was covering from his head straight down to his torso, so Derek was trying to find holes and gaps, and he just couldn't find them. But it's a fight, he's digging in there, and he's doing whatever he has to do. He's not concentrating on where he's punching, he is just punching off of instinct.
When you've got one fighter that's boxing and moving like White, and one that's just coming forward trying to land big shots, in this case, Chisora, if he doesn't get any success, he just doesn't score any points. It's very tiring and cumbersome looking at times from Chisora. Now he's breathing heavy. And White, you know, that will favour White on the judges as he just sits behind the jab and outboxes and outjabs Chisora.
Yeah, just that bit more mobile. Clever in there, Dylian White. But Chisora giving so much credit for forcing every second of this.
What the judges like though, because if Chisora keeps marching forward, landing these body shots, just that sting just seems to have gone out of Chisora's shots. It just didn't seem to be punching with the power they had early on, just forcing it a little bit now.
Interestingly, as I said earlier, Chisora does not know how to take a back step. He is war Chisora, as Adam said earlier. He does not know how to take a back step. Sometimes taking a back step is a tactical move to catch a breather.
Again, he applies the pressure. Chisora, it's a bit wayward, it's a bit tired looking, but he's trying so very hard, and White might have more in the tank here. The fresher, the smarter boxing. Let's get over to Eddie Hearn and David Hay.
Both of you. Eddie looked at me and said, who are you talking to? How are you seeing it? Is your man in front, Dylan White?
I don't really know, to be honest with you. I mean, the point deduction was big. A 10-8 round. I've got it very, very close. I don't know how Sky boys are scoring it.
Very close.
I had Chisora winning. That's a good round for him then. Maybe Chisora won in front right now.
What about you, David?
I've got it close with a 10-8 round. But it's a bit unfair. It's not pretty high. But, you know, I've probably got Derek just nicking at the moment. But a lot of the rounds close. Depends what you like. You like the moving away, what Dylan's doing, or you like the aggression with Derek. I like the aggression, but you know, it's a close fight. It's for any fight to win. It's one of the best fights I've seen. This is like as good, if not better, than the first fight.
Can see George Graham behind you, you put your faces. How are you scoring it?
Fucking haven't even seen it.
How are you scoring it? White's winning. I've got White here, he's doing well. Nice one. Come on, pressure's coming, mate, doing well. Thank you.
Some people have White, some people have Chisora, some people have it level. It's so subjective, but what's not, and what everyone's in agreement, it's been another barn burner here. 6 minutes left of a magnetic rematch. Carl's card, you have it 4 up, Dylian White.
Well, it's looking wider now with that point deduction. I mean, a couple of these close rounds that David Hay was talking about, I think White's just been able to be more effective on his back foot with his boxing, and they're still in the rounds. As Chisora marches forward and has no success, really, it's difficult to score in them rounds, and it's looking wider, my cards are 97-93 to White with the point off. It looks harsh, but White's just being more effective in this second half of the fight with his boxing ability.
They must be so tired.
This is a
fight. Despite all the training here, and Derek for an elbow. Chisorer corner are in utter dismay, and it is now 2 points off for Derek Chisorer, and that is surely massive advantage to Dylian White. If he's not ahead on the cards already, it's another point off Chisorer.
Yeah, such a shame. That's a devastating effect, a massive impact on the scorecard to have 2 points deducted. I mean, that's 2:10.9 round. It's not really acceptable.
And as Anthony was saying earlier, maybe subconsciously, mentally, that's affected Chisora. Whyte came on strong straight after it.
That's it. The ref has such a big job and role in this fight. Without even knowing, we're busy watching Derek Chisora and Dylian Whyte. But if you look close at the ref, he's got his eye close on the fight, dictating how it goes, when they train, how they train.
Well, you know when you're in a close fight, and a couple of points deducted will give you that massive confidence boost. Yeah. He's going to think to himself, now Whyte, he'll be thinking, it's close, but I'm probably ahead, but I'm definitely now winning this with the 2 points deducted. So that'll give you a bit of energy.
Yeah. Sometimes when there's such an intense build-up, and you know you really want to go in there and do something like that, you want to hurt your opponent.
Well, exactly, and they were both in the best possible way. You want to hurt him because you want to knock him out. I mean, it's a KO. That's what you're looking to do. You're looking at doing that. And Derek Chisora went out on his shield there. He left it. He told us he was going to walk Chisora steam forward, and that's what he did. And he exhausted himself. He emptied the tank trying tonight to beat Dylian White, and that's why he's been knocked out. He's really gone out on his shield here. And if that's the last we see of him, then what a fantastic man he is.
Well, he gets the decision first time around by the skin of his teeth, Dylian White. This time it was emphatic. Chisora 3-1, and then boom, left hook. And you know about Dylian White's left hooks.
Yeah, it's ain't about me tonight, Adam. It's ain't about me. But as you said, I know about that left hook. I took one flush as well. He's got a sweet left hook, and that's just something that you'll have to train for. Something you'll have to avoid when you fight Dylian White. He knows what he's doing, and as I wondered early on in the first round, why he didn't jump on Chisora early. He took his time, and it finally paid off. There it is.
Well, they both landed simultaneous left hooks there, but White had the position over him. His front foot was over the punch, and he landed with full impact. And we saw the effect there of Chisora.
Yeah, that doubled it, and it was the end for Derek Chisora with that Dylian White sweet left hook. And interestingly, as we watch this back, the scorecards have come in.
Okay.
And at the time, 95-94,
wow.
95-94 to Chisora on two cards. and 95-94 to Whyte on the other. So Chisorer was so close.
And I was wondering, as the fight gets later on, it's a testament of their conditioning, coaches, because I was thinking, who carries the power later on into the rounds? This is what would be the decider of this fight. As it was such a close fight, who will carry the knockout power into the later rounds?
They put such a shift in tonight again. Incredible courage, incredible effort. And you just will them to both make it to the final bell. But this is the brutality of the sport, and it was definitive from dylian Whyte.
Well, that's right, and we didn't want a controversial close split decision, which is what we might have been heading for. I had Whyte ahead there, two of the judges had Chisorer ahead. You cannot argue with anybody, but that kind of finish just ends the argument, settles it. I mean, that kind of knockout just finishes it off, and Chisorer.
Because I tell you what, I think we would have been heading for a close call and a trilogy. But this time, you know, our thoughts with Derek Chisorer.
100%.
And we want him to have a safe and happy Christmas. That's all he wants to get back to, his young girl and his farm. And for dylian Whyte, it's been the crowning of a great year.
It has. For dylian and for Derek, they got it on. You know, it's been the crowning of a great year for dylian Whyte. He's been consistent. He's been waiting for a title shot. Look, the guy's been consistent. Let's not keep on talking about what happened with me and him in the past. That was the past. We both moved on. Let's see how we both perform now, if we get it on in the future. Derek is a war horse. He's been around for many years, many rounds in the tank, and you can see sometimes it's just wear and tear. Dust himself off, go again, learn from your mistakes. This is what boxing is about.
Nice to see a smile from Don Charles, who's been with Derek Chisorer from the very beginning. Wonderful team, wonderful entertainment. Hats off to the pair of them, but it's dylian Whyte by knockout late.